let's show you some of the concepts of how this radio can be utilized to enhance soldier capability. As you can see, this is a standard objective area with a mission support site, sniper observer, joint terminal attack controller co-located with GFC, and assault force infiltrating over the beach. Ground forces are leveraging naval surface fires, AC-130 gunship, unmanned aerial vehicles, and command SAT. Focusing in on the mission support site, this showcases the STC's two-channel capabilities. On radio side 1, they're using Beyond Line of Sight command SAT, while on radio side 2, they're using TSMX for command talk group or ISO and assault talk group as needed. Zooming in on the assault force, radio side 1 is being used for ground-to-air UHF communications and beyond line of sight communications, while radio side 2 is operating TSMX for the assault talk group. As the assault force nears the target, the objective area becomes one large self-healing network, providing seamless cohesion for all elements. Before, what used to take two handheld radios now only requires one STC. With the added capability of an ISR mission module, all operators have Battlefield SA. Looking back up at the JTAC location, he can directly pull the video downlink with the ISR mission module and, using crossbanding, redistribute it via MANA to all players on the battlefield. For example, the sniper observer can be in the optimal location with no line of sight to the aircraft while receiving ISR video from the JTAC location over the isolated talk group. The ISR video feeds, data, and voice communications are all happening real-time, showing you the powerful and secure networking capabilities you can get all in just one radio. For more information, talk to your Harris representative or go to harris.com.